It's kind of a okay, and we have the turn one sort these, and then the turn two Aegon with two cards in the graveyard for him, and then maybe Mimor, and yeah, I think that's okay. So, my opponent is a stifle player, so we play around the stifle now. Then we just try to try to be as proactive as possible. Oh yes, probably one of his tempo counters, because he's playing a tempo deck. Yeah, okay. Oh, he has a counter again, most likely. Yeah, okay. That means for us, I don't know. I think we just try to present every turn the thing that he has to answer. So this turn means the Aegon, and next turn the Hunted Nightmare probably, or the Liliana. So I think usually these matchups works out that he has a turn to counter, then a creature plus something. So maybe we can kill his next creature with the Liliana. Well, let's play into the counter. Oh, he has no counter, okay. Maybe a bounce? Nothing, okay. It's like a 3-mana threat. Ogre or something. Okay. Now he tries to attacks on the Aegon, which probably will work. This means two cards. Okay. So now, can we do? I think the Aegon will most likely die next turn. We can discard one card to the brutality and play a consultation, probably. I don't know if it is worth it. We can also play like another big threat, which doesn't even have the downside. This will at least draw a card. I don't know, we can play the Badlands, discard this card and search for something. It's also kind of a decent play. I think this is probably okay. So let's drain and discard. No, that's a wrong modus. That's a wrong modus. We mischose. Sorry about that. So we actually drain and discard. Okay. I pay one, discard our land. Okay, burn, burn, burn. Force. So we can. So we can next turn double burn the Aegon with the mana of the Clotus. So yeah, let's take the lightning bolt. Is this left? Now we can choose another creature. Another creature with 4 toughness. Do we have? I don't know. Can go for another planeswalker. Maybe, but that loses to the blue card. House of Negation. You can also get like a Hymne, which would be not too bad, I think. The Hymne to Torak. Can also go for Rankle, maybe. Let's go for the Hymne. So we exile 20 cards. Okay. Right. Let's go. Now he's probably checks our cards. It's not very enlightening, but okay, he doesn't go for the mana. He goes for the drain because he dies to the 6/6. Keeps up the force. Okay, now we can play another big boy. So now he goes to 7. We play 4/4. Which she has to answer again. And the forcible stuff we leave at hand. And we play even though we're on Frostbite. He has another thing. Psychotrium, okay. And we get another big boy. Okay. So 10 damage on the board. But the 6/6 will die. But now he has to care about the 4/5 and then we can probably, I don't know, trade the him still against two cards. Against the Force of Negation blue card probably. Let's see. Doesn't do anything. So that means that he can hard cast the Force. Okay, try to burn us out. Okay. So we will go to 6. And then okay, this diamond's not great. So we play any of our spells that will cause a counter. And we will go to 6 from the Ancient Tomb. Then we have to. No, yes. Yes, Gutshot Force of Negation in hand. So we can resolve our thing. So, which card is better? If we cast to him, so we have to kill the Hex Drinker. So, yeah, let's take the last hope. Try to erase him. Because killing with Liliana will Liliana will die to the gut shot. So yeah. Now we try to finish him. So actually can drain us twice. And then we can't use our Ancient Tomb anymore, so we're still not good. So we can't use the Ancient Tomb anymore. So we attack him, he goes to 3. And I think we die. So maybe we can find another creature with Liliana. I think that's a way to win the game. Get this one. Shit sim for 7. So this has dash. So this could kill him. He has a force and the gut shot and one unknown card. If we just attack, he goes to 3, then we go to 2, then he goes to 5, and we die anyway. So we have to go for the dash guy. Try to kill him. that's good enough. Okay. Ancient tomb. Ancient tomb is kind of a threat sometimes. You accelerate so fast, but then sometimes you are sort of low on life. My opponent is saying that I was lucky, which is, he's probably right about that, but I don't know. He doesn't know the deck, so. So now we have turn two. So turn one, two mana. We can play a demonic. Can play this guy, which draws cards. We probably discard this card. I think that's okay. Probably if he plays keeps the blue land open, then we play around the stifle. Upkeep. Rating. Okay, we got a Grey Fat Hate thingy. So let's play the Moxton. Probably discard and Lantern then. There's a lot of good stuff. He has a stifle, okay. Yeah, the hand's really good. So. The stifle is the least threatening thing. I think the planeswalkers, the counter, and the bounce spell. I think the bounce spell can bounce on Mox, which is frightening. And this can exile the land for the win in 6. So I think that means that we take the bounce spell. Then we play the Graveyard Hate and exile. Let's go. Now, if he wants to keep his land, by stifling, he has to wait one more turn. Now he has like the mana drain and can go into Oko, which is bad too. That means probably that we also say go, because he doesn't have anything. Maybe we can just double spell. We play this one, which gets countered. Then go for something which kills the planeswalker? I don't know. I think we just say go. We can still draw a card with the Soviet Lantern. But I don't know. Doesn't do anything, wants to really mana drain. Okay. So now we can, I think every spell means that he plays the Oko next turn. And Oko goes to 6. So I think we just say go again. And hit with the factory now. Now he has like 3 unknown cards and yeah. Okay. Goes for a third land. His cards are stifled, okay. That's a land, okay. So now we're still in the same situation, but now he can like just play the Oko. So now we have to slam Pervy. So we have 5 mana. Play the mana drain, and then he can. Both. I think the worst threat is this one. No, the worst threat is this one because it has 2 and 6. So just play this one now. Okay, doesn't counter. That's interesting. Because he can win in 6 it probably. But that does mean that he can't play Oko. He also maybe cannot play counter after that. So maybe it was wrong to tap the factory. I thought that he would most likely counter, and therefore wanted to save my life points. So now probably have to exile the graveyard because the land is there now. And goes for the kill. So there's a time. Most likely. Wasteland. Blocker, yeah, that's good. So now doesn't have anything, so we can but now he has a Wasteland Venom 6 lock, which we also can't let him have. So now he can next turn plus, and we still have to do this. Yeah. That's bad. We can, if we hit the land, we can go for the 3-3 with haste. So let's try. Yeah, still the Oko. Yeah, it's all bad. Let's still exercises. Let's still exercise yards. And try to hit the land. No land. So now we get wasteland. And Oakwood. We can go for the vampire, which kills the planeswalker, which also kills Oko next turn. So we can do that. Let's do that. Okay, maybe there's something better than that, but I think it's still the Hexmage. Hopefully he will not kill our second black land, so let's we will attack 1/6 now, and he has to jump. So let's do this. Oh no, he has a wasteland. Oh no, that's really dumb. Oh, I think we lost now. yeah. Probably doesn't see it. okay. Maybe it works. No. Okay, jump. Okay, it doesn't. Wasteland. Okay. Maybe he really wants to kill our black souls. So we both. Are we both. Did we both misplayed here? Maybe. No, he goes for the black land. We don't use it. Okay.
Now he's gonna wasteland us
into the Stone Age. And play Oko. Yeah, that's not good. Nothing. Okay, he wants to really destroy us. I think there's no reason to play Oko, that's right. I think we lost. Weird that I attacked with the factory and he didn't kill it. It seems so odd in many ways, but this was probably right. Do not kill it and go for the black source first. So now we're on the play again. have the clunk spells and snuff out. This will most likely die. This, I don't know. I think we go for. Can we try this? It's a 5 drop. I'll try it. Let's try out the 5 drop. That's why I put it in the deck. Mulligans, okay. So let's play one stifle again. Get the basic and so go. Now we have a snuff out for his first creature, and then maybe some kind of Bob variants. Maybe he will reveal the 5 drop now. I think our first creature will most likely die, so I will play this one first. And then, yeah. Maybe we can resolve the Timaret and grind him out. Wasteland again? Sure. And kill. Should be bad. Of course. And we draw no land. But yeah, we have another land, so the next creature will also die, I think. So then we have to draw land again and resolve all 3 drops. So this has to die. It doesn't die. Okay. So that means that he has a counter spell. Land and the discard spell. Okay, now we attack first. So maybe he kills the creature now and we can resolve the 3 drop. I think we will not cleave. We will tap our non-basic land and go for his counter spell. Okay. Try again. Counterspell, counterspell. Death Witch Shaman. So we can kill one creature, not the Death Witch Shaman. So next turn he can either leave up the counterspell or play the golf. So it's best to take Death Witch Shaman. And then he has still to care about our creature. So maybe that means that he has to play the golf. So there are still a lot of tempo counters left for one mana that he could have. I think that means, I think there's no reason to play this in his turn, so maybe we just F6. Oh, he can play this plus counter spell. Yeah. So now you will most likely counter our removal spell. And then we can resolve our three drops. Or four drops. We can also wasteland him. And this way he can't. So, but then we could not attack. So we will destroy the volcanic. And then play the Tumaret. Yeah, it seems okay. So I'm gonna wasteland now. Just gonna drop mana for no reason. But yeah, there's a reason, but we will not play into the mana, go into the next phase. Now curse creature. And play the Timurat. Maybe we play the Nashi, but no. He will play the golf now, and then we can maybe hit him with the Wrinkle. I think there's a good chance that we hit the land, and now he has to play on the board. So that's good for us. But now we have to play a little bit more, a little bit faster. If we don't tie to the... Okay, it doesn't do anything. He wants that we die to our own Bob. Okay. The land. And the... Ooh. Okay. Now we will counter our spell. We can also get back the Scorpius Grounder. So... We can play a 3-drop spell and get back the Strapping Scrounger. So, it's good. Yeah, let's just do that. Anything that we play, we will put probably on top, and then we take 3 next turn again. But we will hit him for 9, so. And then you will play the golf, and we will play the rank and get him. So I think we will know. Most likely. I really, he hard counters it. Okay. So now we will get the scrounger. This was even better that he countered with the. So otherwise we wouldn't have gotten back the scrounger. So it's good for us. And now we will get 2 life back from the Timurid. Maybe he concedes now. Yeah.